Mike stared in disbelief as his hands fell off. From them rose millions of tiny maggots. Maggots? Maggots. 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 All over the floor of the post office in Leytonstone. Greetings, friend. I hope you're sitting uncomfortably, be it on your sofa, armchair, or beanbag, if that's how you choose to live your life. I'm Garth Marenghi, horror writer. You know, everyone has a special talent. Mine is being able to write, produce, direct, act, paint. Other people are good plumbers, that's their gift. When I wrote, directed and starred in Garth Marenghi's Darkplace back in the 1980s, the television industry was up cack alley, and the inside of my head looked to be its only ticket out. This show could have changed the world, if only the station hadn't cancelled it for a rerun of Who's the Boss. But they were scared of my script's radical predictions. I portended that by the year 2040, the world would see its first female mechanic, and who knows, she might even do a decent job. In any case, I wish her the very best. Still, so much for possibility, French for possibilities. Tonight, I take no small amount of pleasure in bringing you this forgotten episode of Darkplace, along with interviews from myself and my publisher, Dean Lerner, a man who was there during its creation and didn't die or offend me. Take this gift, sit back and enjoy what still points the way forward for humanity. Love, loyalty, sacrifice, and extrasensory perceptive telepathic psychokinetic powers. Voici. You're welcome. I'm Garth Marenghi, author, dreamweaver, visionary, plus actor. You are about to enter the world of my imagination. You are entering my dark place.
The fish.
Fish is off.
How long is it going to take the so-called chef to cook this chicken? Sorry, I'm not usually this bad-tempered. I'm just really peckish.
Don't be silly. I should be thanking you for looking after me so well.
No problem. I know that first days can be a real pain in the ass.
Who's that? He seems to have a special aura around him.
That's Dr. Rick Douglas, MD, the world-famous GP. He's a brilliant yet troubled man, and I'm privileged enough to know him. Here, I'll introduce you.
The doctors want their chicken.
Tell the doctors the chicken will be ready in 5 minutes.
Son of a bitch.
Whoa, what's going on with that chicken?
5 more minutes.
You said 5 minutes.
Do you know what's going on with this flipping chicken?
The word is it'll be ready in 5 minutes.
I'll believe that when I see it.
Tell me about it. Have you met the temp?
Listen, sweetheart, I've not got time to shoot the shit. So why don't you and your new boyfriend carry some chicken out to my office when it comes?
If it ever comes.
Hey, are you all right?
No, I mean, yes, I deserve that. Where's this flipping chicken?
Who said that?
Was it you, Missy? Get this into your pretty little face. I said 5 minutes. But nothing. Women like you are the reason this chicken's late in the first place. You'll be lucky if you get any of my lovely chicken if you keep up this kind of behaviour. Goddamn son of a bitch. This is great chicken. Getting nothing but flack. When's the chicken? The chicken's ready when I say it's ready. I don't even know what I'm cooking. I'm so angry. Seasoning. Now, what do I need? What do I need? Tarragon? Maybe. A bit of oregano. Never heard of it. Italian seasoning. Too vague. Old cloves. Yeah, I'll put some of them in. Sage? Yeah, sage is from pork. No, I can do pork tomorrow. I'll need a bit of pork. Come on.
Oh.
Son of a bitch.
If I had to call myself anything, and I hate labels, I would probably say I'm an imaginer.
I call Garth the Orson Welles of horror, and that's not just because of his weight. He is a titan of terror. I call him that as well.
There are rebels and there are innovators. I'm a rebel. I play a rebel brain expert who's in rebellions against conventional logic, who's in rebellions against the world order. The show is about rebellions. And if that's not being an innovator, then I don't know what is.
My name is Dr. Rick Douglas, MD. I hadn't been sleeping lately. Not that Darkplace lets you get much sleep. The pillows are like cardboard and my duvet's all lumpy. Got the call, chef down, and no, it can't wait till morning. Poor guy, ladled to the head and a fork where a fork don't fit. This damned evil place was getting crazier by the day. Morning all, cheer up Liz, how's chef?
How do you think the guy's got a fork through his kernel? He's gonna make it just... but the chicken's off.
That's a shame. I was looking forward to the chicken. Gentlemen and Liz, it seems as though we have a mystery attacker in Darkplace. I suggest we split up and search the hospital. Dag, you, Samson the Temp, can search all the wards in the basement. Me and Liz will stay here and search this office.
Wait a minute. Me and Samson are a team. We don't need a third wheel.
Look, Dag, this temp was a personal recommendation of Wanton's. He might look like he's just fallen off the back of a turnip truck, but he wouldn't run if his ass was on fire. He goes with you, and that's a deal-breaker.
Fine, but if he makes any administrative errors, I'll bust his hump, and that's a promise.
Look, at least you're not going with Liz.
That's true.
Now get out of here. God, I wish I was hitting the wards with those young bucks. But I'm old, tired, spent, busted, rusted, stuck in a mouldy old office with just a moody woman for company. Liz, that bulb's gone again. You couldn't fish another one out from the drawer, could you?
All of us have untapped potential. You know, that's what the Garth Marenghi Foundation is all about, learning to harness psychokinetic abilities in underprivileged kids. We've got the full backing of the army. There's already a child down there who's very intuitive.
Now, I've seen Garth bend a fork, so he knows what he's talking about. I mean, we all have abilities. I mean, I once learned how to hypnotise women. But with that power must come responsibility.
Did you attack the chef? Thanks for your time. Did you attack the chef? Thanks for your time. Did you attack the chef? Thanks for your time.
I'll say one thing for the guy. He's very thorough.
I don't like it. Don't you find it funny that all this started to happen when the temp arrived?
What do you reckon? Android?
It'll make sense. I've not seen him eat or drink anything since he arrived this morning, and it's 1 p.m. now, so...
Sounds right. What should we do?
Just keep him peeled. We might need to kill him.
Uh-huh. Bye. Good gravy. A small bunch of objects are flying of their own accord in E-Wing. And apparently more objects are heading this way. Goodbye. Flying objects? It beggars belief.
Well, we've asked everyone in the hospital if they're the mystery attacker, and they've all said no.
And so that's why we're searching the hospital basement?
Exactly.
Dag, we're too late. Looks like our man struck again.
Negative, Sanch. This ain't a fresh kill. In fact, they don't look like a kill at all. Guy probably came down, got lost, went mad, ate his hands, and died right here. Come on. There's nothing we can do for him now. Keep close. These tunnels are really long and curvy.
Hug the wall.
What is it?
Cordless iron. Friggin' smarts as well.
Of course. That's why these attacks are mysterious. They're not conventional attacks.
What is it?
I've got two words for you, Sanj. Telekinesis.
Telika what?
Telekinesis. Someone or something is propelling objects around this hospital.
But who and why and for what reason?
I don't know yet. People do develop telekinetic abilities in some rare cases. Often the subject feels angry or unappreciated. How are you two doing up there?
I'm fine, but I'm having to tread on eggshells vis-a-vis Liz. She's got a face like the proverbial. I think it's her time.
Well, you can tell her from me, if I felt sorry for myself 5 days every month, this hospital will be up the creek, sans paddle.
Tell me about it. No one gave me any time off when I had troubles in a similar area. I mean, she's a right roll pain in the butt.
Reed?
It's the phone.
Reed!
What, Dag? Hello?
LP-519, this is Douglas. I repeat, this is Douglas. It's ringing.
Right, look at the noise! Country all over this show!
Everything by the kitchen sink.
How about your kitchen sink at all?
Jesus.
I can't hold these plates off much longer, Liz! Why don't you help instead of just standing there dreaming about lipstick? Holy cow! It's you, isn't it? You're doing this! I just hope Douglas makes it up here in time.
Split up! Split up!
Get a wriggle on. It's me! See you soon, Dag!
Liz, I want you to be calm.
No, Liz. No.
Reed.
Jim, in here, quick. Tell Dag it's Liz.
Okay, I'll get help.
And hurry!
To Rick Douglas. Ah! Ah! No!
You again, you bastard.
Things come alive in my head. Suck on that. Escaped it. Filing cabinet.
In times of conflict, when you're up against an aggressor, be he human, be he inhuman, whoe'er he be, often he's both, you're running on adrenaline. And that is what you have to capture in the mise-en-scene. And then you add to that the supernatural element.
An eagle-eyed viewer might be able to see the wires. A pedant might be able to see the wires. But I think if you're looking at the wires, you're ignoring the story. If you go to a puppet show, you can see the wires, but it's about the puppets. It's not about the string. You go to a Punch and Judy show and you're only watching the wires, you're a freak.
Yeah, it's me, Dag. I'm in a dead end. I've been cornered by some cutlery. I think I can take them. A whisk, a tin opener, and a spatula. Yeah, I'll take the whisk out first and hold them off as long as I can. Ah! I'm hit, I'm down. Yeah, got me in the leg. They'll be after you next. Bye.
Let's do this.
It's just you and me now, kiddo. Hello, Dr. Ray Douglas speaking. How may I help you? Bye. That was Jim. He said that Liz is the source of all this telekinetic activity. She's pinned Reed against the wall of his office and is propelling objects around as a kind of guard outside the room. He also added that I ought to hot-tail it up there right away, which means going all the way back to where we originally set out from, which is an irony in itself. You stay here.
But Rick!
No buts. You're a good temp. You've got a lot of clerical work ahead of you. Don't blow it all by getting yourself killed.
There's a lot of slow motion. The episodes were running up to 8 minutes under. The only way to stretch them out was with slow motion. And we tried to keep the slow motion away from the dialogue as much as possible. But anything without dialogue was considered for slow motion.
I ran the only way I knew how, by placing one leg in front of the other in quick succession. I had to help Reed, trapped in his office by a desk he could no longer trust. I had to help Sanchez, locked in primal struggle twixt man and Wisp.
Wisp to the neck!
And I had to help the temp, who was probably doing some filing or data entry. I pressed on, chased by a stapler that had my name on it. This was unbelievable. Liz was now turning my own stationery against me. What would she throw at us next?
Garth's name is...
As I rounded the corner, I felt muscular and compact, like corned beef. Irony of irony, all this paper meant more paperwork. And look at that, I thought in my head. Liz has even struck the kiddie wing.
If only someone would set up a foundation to harness kids' psychokinetic powers.
This sorry madam was about to get a double dose of Darkplace Douglas medicine. Liz, hide your shame.
From Bermuda.
Oh, that explains it. British Principality.
It's actually a dependent territory.
What's that?
The Queen appoints a governor charged with internal security and external defense, but she's still the de facto sovereign.
We had so much to teach each other. I'm going to miss you, Clive. I'm going to miss the banter, which is fizzed from the get-go. And as I say,
I'm gonna miss your balls.
I
can't hear you.
Who's supposed to file this?
I'll get Liz to do it first, then. Under the circumstances, it's the least she can do. Don't you dare, Don.
I suppose I owe you all an apology. And Sanj?
Yes, Liz?
Thanks for the lobotomy.
Not a problem. The procedure to extract psychokinetic ability is in its infancy, though surprisingly simple all the same.
I guess being told that I couldn't get a chicken supper was the straw that broke this camel's back. It was unprofessional and girlish. It won't happen again. Buns?
I've seen a couple I fancy.
I bake them by way of apology.
And so ends a chapter in a book I fear is yet to close, right, Dag?
I just can't believe the temp is dead.
It's all right, Rick. We'll get another one.
It's not that. I guess I kind of liked the kid. He reminded me a lot of myself at that age. I was wild.
That's true.
Full of ideas, going knuckle to knuckle with anyone in authority, real Jimmy Dean. Guess we were two peas punching it out on the same pod. I just hope that when the temp died, he realised how much we taught one another, you know, that it weren't just one-way traffic.
I'm sure if it had any breath left in his body, he'd have used it to thank you.
Well, you'd hope.
Come on, Dag. What's that? Buy us all a drink down the drip.
I'd appreciate that. I could use a drink.
As long as it's not a screwdriver.
Yes, I'd prefer a beer. Dear me. Oh dear.
Oh dear. Oh, goodness.
We'd seen a new side to Liz. Hell hath no fury like a woman scorned. They can get upset at the slightest thing, whether it be forgetting to acknowledge them in front of one's friends, or insisting on splitting a restaurant bill in proportion to the cost of food that was actually ordered by each party, even though that's only fair. I'd have to try and change. Tomorrow I'd tell her she'd lost weight, or that her hair looked nice, whichever seemed more plausible.
I think what this episode shows above all is that the human spirit cannot be overcome. You know, as a writer, if you took away my paper, I would write on my heart. If you took away my ink, I'd write on the wind. It wouldn't be an ideal way to work.
Marenghi's Darkplace is a Garth Marenghi production in association with Dean Lennon.